Boxing trainer George Diaz, the man with 1,000 moves. You can move like anyone from James Toney to Klitschko to Pacquiao and Mayweather. Gotta ask you about this fight. Chavez Jr., Peter Manfredo?
I'm gonna have to go with Chavez. I think Peter Manfredo has lost too much weight for that fight.
A lot of people online are telling me Manfredo is gonna destroy Chavez. Why'd they say that?
Just because he's been around a lot longer, but you gotta look at it, the significance that Manfredo has fought at a lot higher weight.
That's true.
He hasn't been making when has he made 160? It's been a year since the contender.
And people complain about his punching power. Do you think, does he have a punching power?
I can't really say, you know, I know he has.
He never hit you.
He never, yeah, exactly. So, I just think Chavez. Chavez makes
okay.
That fight.
Who's next for Chavez if he wins? Him against, let's say, who's at 160? You have Kid Chocolate. You have Sergio Martinez. You have, who else do you have that?
I don't think Chavez Jr. is ready for Sergio Martinez. Sergio Martinez he's just at another stage of his career. Chavez, I don't think he's ready for that type of challenge yet. Kid Chocolate, I can see that's a good opponent. I'm not really impressed with Kid Chocolate. Not to put.
He might fight Paul Williams next. I just found out today.
Ooh. Paul Williams has been, you know, since that last performance with Lara, that's a big question mark. He beat Craig McEwen, you know, really didn't show me much. So, nothing against Kid Chocolate. He just is a rising prospect, but.
Okay. How about this fight, Cotto Margarito? Because the 154 division is on fire now. With Kirkland beating Pero.
I can't call that fight. You know, the situation about the whole hand wrap situation. I don't know what's going on, if it's true or not. So I can't say because I wasn't only they know and God knows whatever Margarito did. But the thing is, I don't know how psychologically Cotto is affected of that. And the other thing is, how?
I have to ask all you guys here really quick. You heard about Joel Casamayor getting busted? He busted for
marijuana.
He took the wrong drug. Marijuana doesn't make you stronger. He should have taken other substances. That's the wrong substance.
It loosens you up.
It makes you. The one day he looked kind of like relaxed. He was falling down.
You know, Casamayor was a stunning fighter back in his day.
You sparred him.
Yeah.
How hard does he hit?
Oh, people underestimate his power.
Hard does he hit when he's high?
I don't know. I never sparred him when he was high, but no. People underestimated Casamayor. Really, Bradley didn't show me much. You know, Bradley, no disrespect. He didn't show me much. He, you know, Casamayor at the stage of his career. A guy like him, you know, he was basically over the hill. You know,
George,
he shouldn't have been in the ring with him.
Okay. Did Marquez show you something you didn't know? Did Manny show you
something
you didn't know?
You know, like I've always said, the reason. The whole thing with Pacquiao, you know, now everybody knows what I've been saying for a couple years now. Now Pacquiao's been exposed. He's not something from this out of this earth. He's just human like everybody else.
You're saying he's Superman without the powers right now?
No, he's never been Superman.
He's
never been Superman.
George, they're gonna call me a pack tart, and you've seen the comments.
You know, like everybody says the pack tart. I'm gonna use this term for the first time. For all pack tart things that I'm hating on Manny, I'm not hating on Manny.
You used to spar him.
Yeah,
George, how can you say he's an ordinary fighter?
Because something. That's
but he beat Margarito. He beat Cotto. He beat Hatton. He beat De La Hoya.
You can say the same thing about Roy Jones. Roy Jones was Superman at one time.
That's true.
What happened?
He got knocked out in Russia.
So that's
by
nobody is Superman in this sport. If people think you're Superman, you're mistaken.
But you said he's an ordinary fighter, so that means
he is.
He's 144, 145. If he steps in the ring tomorrow with Jesus Soto Carras, does Soto Carras beat him?
You know something? That's the challenge, the way to be seen. You know, I never want to put no fighter down. I've been happy for Manny's accomplishments. Of course, he's done great for his country. He holds a country behind him.
So you're not hating?
I'm not hating. I look at accomplishments.
Is Manny Pacquiao an ordinary fighter, or is he a superstar legend? He says he got exposed against Marquez. Marquez, like, he would look like a regular person.
And he did.
You didn't see the fight?
No, he did. He did look regular against him. He did.
You gotta look at the type of fighters Pacquiao has fought throughout the years. Marquez an exception. Marquez is a counterpuncher. What is all the other fighter he's ever fought? They're
come
mostly
forward,
aggressive,
yeah.
coming forward. They're all been tailor-made. Am I hating on him for beating that? No, I'm happy for him for accomplishing what he's accomplished. You cannot take nothing away from him. But he's not. I don't see him being this.
You know what's funny, George? You're gonna laugh at this one. How many Pacquiao fights have I been covering now? 7, 8?
Yeah,
every time you prove you wrong.
Yes.
The one time you didn't go against him, Marquez did good. Maybe yeah. stop going for the guys going against Manny.
No, but I'm gonna tell you this right now. If that fight happened with Floyd Mayweather, he gets knocked out. Pacquiao gets knocked out. I think he gets stopped.
Floyd knocks out Manny?
Yeah.
Floyd knocks out Pacquiao.
That fight does not go more than 8 rounds.
Wow, there you have it. You heard it here first. If Manny Pacquiao fights Floyd Mayweather, the fight is going down in 8 rounds. You heard that, Ricky? He said Mayweather knocks out Pacquiao in 8 rounds.
Mayweather. Yeah, I don't know how to think about knocking him out, but I think he'll beat him.
He stops.
I wanna.
You saw what he saw. He wasn't able to adjust.
Let me ask you a question, really quick.
Marquez's style.
Ricky, if 10 goose put a goose on their T-shirt, what animal should I put on my shirt?
What reminds me of a setback?
A what?
What animal?
What's that animal? Famous animal from Israel?
A cactus? A camel?
Nah.
We're famous for donkeys. I don't know. Camels.
I'm gonna put a llama.
A llama?